Okay, let's get started. This is the effect handlers session of the ML workshop, and Oleg is going to kick it off.
So this talk is about effects and F language. So you probably everybody heard about algebraic effects, so Bretnar and Plotkin's paper. And effect language is a language created by Andre Bauer and Mattia Bretnar that implements those ideas of their calculus. Effect is mostly OCaml with some extra declaration that makes it effect. So there is a compiler from effects into OCaml, and there is an optimizer compiler recently that compiles into OCaml. So what this talk does, so instead of compiling effects, language effect into OCaml, it just embeds effects in OCaml directly in a idiomatic fashion. So you don't need any compilation, you just use a standard OCaml and implement all these constructions of effect, I mean, in roughly the same syntax as the inf. So it means that OCaml becomes sort of another F implementation. And we see how it performs. And we have two different kind of backends how to implement effectful part, either using the LIMCC library or OCaml effects. So one interesting thing which is of this work is effect has so-called dynamic effects, and I will talk about it later about what they are. And we realized that dynamic effects or high order effects, they are themselves effects, so and they can be treated as irregular effects. And so that was dealing with this effect dealing with this high order effects has been a problem in F, and now it's I think the problem can be solved. So, although I think everybody heard of algebraic effect and many people heard of language F, I think that probably not many people actually seen F. Okay. So this is the F code written kindly for me by Andre Bauer himself. So it looks mostly as OCaml itself, but there is the first thing is the effect declaration. And it defines, defined a signature of three operations, effectual operation. There is operation fail that takes no argument, the operation choose that takes two arguments and deterministically chooses. Oh. Oh, font. Oh. Okay. Okay. Let's see if I can. That's the last one. Yes, as you can see. Well,
it can be made bigger.
No. Well, it can be smaller. So. Okay.
Yeah, okay. Control X plus.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing, but it's already too.
What's the command called? Meta X?
No. No, but this is a different file, so. Okay. I just think during the talk is not.
Text scale increase. Now scales better. Text scale increase.
It doesn't go further. That's the last one. So sorry, that's the last one. So so the declaration only tells the names of effects and what the parameters, and that's operation of cow, I don't know, Andre introduces for some reason, I'm vegetarian, it escapes me. So after you define the effect operations, that the next thing you do is instantiate it. So you create a new instance of effect. And then you can use it. So for example, this code, it chooses uses operation choose to choose one of the two between A and B and one string and immediately prints it. And then chooses between C and D and immediately prints it. Well, what's the meaning of it? Well, so far we only defined operations, how to use it, define the signatures, but the meaning is defined by the handlers, and that's where the handlers come in. So that's another feature of F. So it says handler is handle the computation F applied to computation, well, F thunks, and it tells how to handle it. So if the computation finished successfully, it simply returns, well, I mean, its value. And if the computation asks for the effect, for example, choose, and it takes, you specify what to do with the payload, which is the values X and Y from V2 choose, and continuation K. And in this case, we choose, well, we continue with X, and then we continue with Y. So we do exhaustive search. We can do something more interesting, so we don't actually have that to do, that's standard, so we can use continue with X, continue with Y, and then combine result in some kind of interesting way. I mean, it's the most interesting way that will come up. And there are more interesting things you could do. For example, in this more complex example, you have the computation choose, handle, then there is a nested handling. So with this computation, outer computation, you have an inner computation, but it's handled in a different way. So the operation choose and cow are handled separately. And the inner handler handles only cow and choose, but does not handle failure, for example. So if your inner handle doesn't handle whatever else, gets propagated to the outer handler. And the inner handler can also use the choose operation, in which case this choose is handled by the outer handler. So it's pretty much looks like exceptions, roughly, right? So all, the same idea, which how it was actually originated. So now we show how that code can be translated directly in OCaml, as I said. If we defined type F result, then we can effect declaration becomes the regular standard OCaml declaration. And it's roughly in the same, matches very closely effect declaration of F. So we define operations and define the types and define the arguments and define the type of the result, yeah. After we introduce a little bit of syntactic sugar, operations choose and fail and small cow operations, which are very, very straightforward and you can be generate automatically, we can start using them immediately. So to instantiate effects, well, we use delimited CC operations library, new prompt. And then we write the code, for example, choosing among two strings, printing and choosing among two strings, well, almost the same way as it's written in F. Well, what about handling? Well, after some small bit of infrastructure, the function handle it, the code for handling looks pretty much the same as in F code. So the only difference, noticeable difference, that the handlers in F, they're deep handlers, so they automatically reapply. And in OCaml, I had to reapply handled by manually. So therefore, instead of just KX, I had to then wrap it around handler. But everything else, as you can see, the sort of the code is roughly follows the same pattern. And the complex example with lots of nested handlers and so forth can be done can be written in a rather similar way. Okay, where is it? Okay. So we define the handlers, we choose it, we can use nested handling, and within nested nested scope uses special handling for operations, and in this nested handler we can use a choose operation that goes to the outer handler. So just done quite straightforwardly. So the more interesting part is that part about static and dynamic effects and so forth. So effects so far, they're called static, and I will illustrate more about it using the state effect as a running example. So we can very easily define the effect of getting piece of the global state or effect of getting piece of state and effect of putting piece of state of, and alpha is the type of the state. And of course we can write a handler for the effect that if now I use our camera than f, so if we for the get operation, then I'm gonna know we get the past the continuation the value of that of the current value of the state, and put of course then modifies it. And then we can handle it. So this a prompt, so we create a new instance of effect, we can think about a reference cell, and then we can perform handling it. So when you look at the code, it looks like the name of the reference cell, well, A in this example, instance of effect, this has to be, it's a globally, kind of, you can think about statically known, the static effects. So Simon asked me a question a week ago about static effects and dynamic effects, the one that I implemented were the names of all the variables are statically known, and so far it's indeed how we use a state effect. But it's kind of tantalizing to think about, if we have the state effect, can we use exactly the same handler for creating arbitrarily number of reference cells, right? Because a reference cell is kind of, well, it is a instance of the state effects. And it looked like before like a state effect, but what's needed for the truly reference cells, because we can create in a loop as many reference cells as we want, right? And each of them maybe have a separate type and as many as they want, each of them can have several type. So how we can actually do that? So what we need to do is that if we have this new ref declaration, we wanted it to expand into something like this. Where there's dot, 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 it means the rest of the program. So it means that new ref should be expanded into new prompt. Well, that's actually easy to accomplish. It's a local transformation. But we also want to wrap around, on the top of it, actually, around it, this handle it and handle ref. And that seems to be kind of hard to do. And it was indeed hard to do in F, and therefore F introduced its own peculiar construct how to introduce this top-level handler. And it's kind of very difficult implementation, and they removed it from F3.1 because it turns out too difficult to deal with. Although they might reintroduce it in F5. Or maybe not, because now, they can use OCaml. Well, it turns out creation of the effects, you don't need to do anything special. So you can define effect that creates other effects, which is a high order effect. So the new effect takes a handler and creates the new instance of the effect and uses the pass handler to handle that user's effect. So what you can see, how handler for that new effect is implemented, it kind of follows the pattern which we saw previously. So it creates a new prompt, passes this prompt to the continuation, and wraps around the whole program, including continuation, with this handle P and this with this handle. So that's all to it. Well, of course, to see how it actually works, you can create new reference cell as the new instance. Well, new instance is just, sending this new effect. New instance of the state request. And then for a type, you can see polymorphic, right? So it really creates arbitrarily number, arbitrarily type reference cells. And of course, if you look at the types which appear somewhere, it's a higher rank type, right? So, and this is existential. You can see it's not as straightforward as might kind of think, but you don't have to write this one. It's written only once. And one interesting part of it, that because new effect is like a regular effect, then you can write your own handler for the new effect. So you can handle high order effects locally. So you can, for example, implement transactional storage where it handles effects for creating new reference cells just only within the local scope. Okay, and about performance. So Casey sent me this graph that looks at the performance of the Qwint benchmarks. So one of the, it's normalized to implementation using just option type. And orange, this part, it's a effect compiled using optimized F compiler into a CAML. So if it's used original compiler F, it's, I mean, the results is very bad. And the well, different orange next to it is the one that using code that I just showed. The translation, I mean, Qwint benchmarks can be implemented much, I mean, nicer in DLIMCC, but I wrote benchmark exactly using the pattern that you just saw. And you can see the performance, I mean, well, compatible. So optimized compiler that took them several years to develop could be, I mean, implemented what took several hours at the actual seminar to embed in a CAML. So it's, comparable performance. And there is a recent development after I, the paper was submitted and probably after it was accepted, somehow Nick Paladinos got a copy of the paper, I don't know how, and he sent me a message that he read it and he implemented this approach in F-sharp using computational expression, which is very actually, I mean, looks very nice, and there is a link to this, so you can see how it works. So now F is available not only in OCaml, but in F-sharp as well. So as in a summary, we showed the idiomatic embedding of effect in OCaml, which uses very local and local translation of effect. And as the code which I showed in OCaml, it's essentially cutting, pasting of effect code into OCaml and adjusting some syntactic differences. And performance was relatively good. And the conclusion to that we get set of OCaml idioms for effectful programming. And for dynamic effects, it turns out dynamic effects are treated just exactly as ordinary effects, and we can even perform local handling of new effects and so forth. So just high-order effects are the same as local effects. And as additional conclusion, there is a turns out to be independently developed, well, not independently, well, independent implementation of the ideas in the paper in F-sharp. And there is a code in this URL. Thank you.
So we've time for questions.
Yes.
So what is the purpose of PAL? Just to return a new version of the old state modified or something like that?
Well, I think you wanted to add the operation that, well, F takes, fail has no argument, choose takes two arguments, and he added operation that takes one argument. So, effectful operation. So he wanted just to demonstrate. But the meaning of how it, of course, it depends on the interpreter, right, on the handler. So you can interpret, whichever you like. He simply wanted to have a signature, something that has only one argument.
Cow is what Andre uses instead of foo.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I had a question on the performance. So you say, oh, good performance. But I see several times slower. So I understand that it's as good as F, which is not very good. Okay. And I also see that you have this green stuff on the.
Okay.
And I can see what it means.
Okay, I should have actually explained. So this, the graph is a slowdown versus option level, right? So therefore, the bigger is worse.
Yeah. So I understand that. Yeah. And yeah. You say it's good. Well, it depends. That's a subjective notion, but it's still. My question is, what's the green stuff here?
Okay, the green is the multi-core CAML, and then Casey can comment whether it was implemented directly through a translation.
It was a translation.
Okay.
Through DLIMCC.
Okay. So it's a translation, it's instead of DLIMCC, it uses the same code, but use multi-core CAML, or CAML opt for implementing the DLIMCC.
You could say, for the purpose of this talk, that it's a different implementation of DLIMCC.
Yes. Well, because it uses not copying stack implementation. Yes.
Yeah.
use effects in multicolor camel, or does it actually use multicores in multicolor camel?
No, it doesn't use multiple cores. It just uses effects.
Okay.
And for the derivative continuation, we use the length fibers that are provided by multicore.
Yeah,
but otherwise, the
encoding. It's still single call, right?
Sorry?
It's still single call.
It's still single call.
Okay.
For example, I have a question. In one of the early examples, for two, you showed the one where it does it the first and then does the second.
Yeah.
But in another handler, you did something where you like add these up.
Yeah.
So, but how can you do that when you don't know that the thing that you use that handler will have a memory effect? I mean, it seems to me like there. Depending on what exactly the result type is going to be at the implications of that effect. How does that
work? Okay, you're probably asking this part, yes. This one, right? So, as I said, that the handlers in F, they're deep handlers. Right, so they wrap around when you ask k apply to x, then all the non-determinism has been handled. So it has to return.
Okay, but why does it have to be a number?
Kx plus, how does that happen?
Okay, well, because.
What if in my effective computation I also have something?
Well, K of X, it depends on the answer type, right? And the answer type is, you know, you can see it's a 10 multiplied by X, it means an integer, right? It means that K of X is better return an integer.
Handlers don't have to be parametric.
And oh, actually, here is a kind of better example, right? So test four. So here, the answer type is not a V, it's a list of Vs, right?
So the k of x is kind of like it has the same type as the result type of the full effective computation, not the condition at the step where it goes up here. So it's a single type for the.
And then here you can see because it returns a list, then we can concatenate them. And the same thing happens in OCaml code. Yeah, for example, this one.
So you could write this as a function from an effective computation. This depends on the fact that the effective computation you're doing here eventually results in a number or a...
Yeah, well, I mean, it's answer type polymorphic, of course, but then when you handle, then answer type gets instantiated to whatever handler returns, right? It means the continuation would return that type, right? And so, that therefore, it's type checks.
Any more questions? Yep.
So, if you go back to the performance graph.
Okay.
It looks like even with multicore OCaml, sometimes you get a factor of two or three slowdown. So I was wondering, is there any?
No, slowdown
compared to
Option, which is not F, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
That's my question. So okay. It's sort of a strong argument against using the higher order construction.
Okay. So, yes.
So that was done for a very short time. So it was like. 2x is possible.
Okay.
And that's the reason why you can see 2x performance difference. As you go up, the performance difference is flat.
Okay.
Yeah, so maybe I look at this graph, so that option and multicore are almost the same, right? Effect F itself with optimizing compiler has big slowdown, and this embedding has smaller slowdown, right?
Yeah, so what I was wondering, like, when I write a program, often, like, I run a deperfect in the effect, but I want to sort of stage it so that, sort of that module control.
Say it again. What?
So I might want to write a module that's parametric in its traceability.
dynamics of implementation.
Okay.
But I don't want to dynamically vary it at runtime, it's sort of a compile time. I select one and then.
I mean, yeah, straightforward. I mean, I know using Metal Camel generated actually. I mean, the head version of effects with Metal Camel, Jeremy Yalop uses it, so you can use both of them at the same time, right? So, and on DLimCC as well, right? I mean, you generate code, you benchmark which one works better, and then say, okay, from now on, I'm going to use this one.
All right, that's finished, and let's thank Oleg again.